So this is the Geek edition of how does your chain affect your suspension? There are many different factors when you're talking about suspension kinematics, things like brake jacking, anti-squat, but the one we're talking about today is pedal kickback and how your chain tension affects your suspension action. So what is pedal kickback? Well, I do talk about that in the main feature, but basically it's when your rear suspension moves, your rear axle actually moves away from that crank set and that stretches the chain. Of course, chains don't stretch. So what actually happens is the crank tries to rotate backwards, but your weight is stopping it from doing that. So that chain tension actually restricts your suspension movement. But that isn't all negative, because that does actually keep the bike firmer and more stable when it comes to pedaling. And it makes that bike a better pedaler if you have a decent amount of anti-squat on the bike. You're talking about that bike not being super supple. It's all about being more agile and a faster pedaling bike. And that does work well for things like this. This is a Nukeproof Mega. It's an enduro bike that needs to be able to pedal well. It also keeps the bike higher in its travel. So when you're talking about going through big compressions, things you want to pump really hard, you're not going to sink in so far and lose all that effort. But it doesn't make your suspension as supple. So if we're talking about pure suspension action through the roughest terrain, through rocks, roots, it's not going to work as well as a bike that doesn't have a chain or any tension on it. That bike is therefore going to move a lot more if the chain's not pulling. So I'll try and give you a quick example of what pedal kickback is. So I've taken the shock out so I can really move the bike through its travel. I've butted the rear wheel up against something so it can't move. You see how the crank there is pretty much horizontal. If I now push the suspension down, it actually tips back. So imagine if your weight is on that, it's stopping that from rotating back. So therefore that tension is going right through the chain. It's actually restricting your rear suspension. Something we see most mountain bike rear mechs come with now is a clutch. Now that's designed to put tension into the bottom of the chain. So this part here, you see with it, that's with it off, so the cage actually pushes forward. With it on, that now won't push forward. So that means it's much tighter, so your chain isn't going to bounce off that chain ring. So they've become much more popular with enduro bikes, trail bikes, you know, short travel bikes that are getting ridden pretty hard. Chains can bounce off them if you don't have a clutch. So it helps with that. However, that again, that's something else that adds more tension into that system. And it does affect the sensitivity of your rear suspension. We've seen a couple of incredible rides. Aaron Gwynn, it must have been a couple of years ago now, at Leo Gang, where he snapped his chain at the start gate, went on to win the race with an absolutely amazing run. Of course, Aaron is an unbelievable rider, super talented. But it did get everyone thinking about how your chain affects your suspension. We've seen the same thing happen just a couple of weeks ago with Rachel Atherton at Fort William. Again, snapped a chain out of the start gate. It's a pretty physical track. The top isn't quite so pedally, but really it was on a motorway section with loads of big jumps that she managed to clear and actually make time on a lot of the girls without a chain was really, really impressive. But it just goes to show that full suspension bikes, that rear suspension really does work well without that tension on the chain. So of course you can get rid of the chain, but that's not very practical for most mountain bikers. So what we're looking at here is trying to devise a system that really gives you almost a neutral gear so that your chain can rotate around the cassette, not be in one of those teeth and actually restrict that suspension. Now, I'm not claiming to invent this at all. It's actually Chris Porter, who's a guy from Mojo Suspension in the UK, who's done this with bikes in the past. He's experimented with loads of things, things like putting weights, so lead weights on the frame of the bike, on the rougher tracks to try and plow through the bumps. And I've seen him do this with spacers. So basically your chain runs down, sits on that plastic spacer, so it just rolls around it. It won't really wear your chain out because it's just plastic. I've only ridden this morning, probably done 8 runs on it, and I've actually worn 2 sort of ruts into this plastic spacer already. So it's not gonna last forever, but I have found it's been really effective. My suspension has been working really, really, really well today. And actually it's not completely stopped me from pedaling because I can put it onto that spacer. When I do get to a slower section, I can bang it up through the gears and eventually the chain will pull itself back up onto the cassette. I'm not saying it does it very nicely and I don't think the chain would last very long if I kept doing it. I definitely could risk snapping a chain doing it, but it works. So I've actually really enjoyed riding the bike like this. You get, you know, some good cranks out at the start, make sure you're still in your proper gear if you're still pedaling, and then whack it into the neutral, give it a quick check to make sure you're there. And then it's all about your riding craft, really trying to rail the corners, get some nice wide lines, roll out as fast as you can, pump as hard as you can, and the suspension really does feel completely different, to be honest. It works really well. I really find in some of the steeper, rough corners where I'm braking hard, it feels much smoother and much faster. But it's not without its flaws. My chain has bounced off these spacers and wedged itself into the frame. Luckily, it's an aluminium back end on my Mega, so it's not doing too much damage, although it doesn't look that pretty. And once it's wedged in there, I'm really not benefiting it at all. Obviously, I can't pedal. And then it's adding more tension into the system, so it's stopping my suspension working as well. Again, once it's gone in there, I'm finding that it's actually starting to drop off the chainring as well. So it's sort of game over once your chain has come off. I'm sure I could tweak it a bit more, put a different spacer on there, try and stop it from doing that. It's actually a pretty simple system that I've done here, and I'll just show you exactly how I've done it. So it's really simple to try this mod. What I've done is got three bottom bracket spacers, I think they are. Doddy found these in his toolbox. And then just taken off my 11 and my 13 tooth sprockets. So this is a Shimano XT cassette. So they do come apart super easily. You can't do this with something like a SRAM Eagle where it's just a one piece cassette. And then replace those two sprockets with three of these spacers and stick my lockering back on. That just gives me a good amount of space for the chain to sit there. I definitely think this could be improved. It could do with maybe a sort of wider spacer behind the lock ring so that the chain can't drop off the bottom of these spacers and then get wedged in your frame. Of course, I'm doing this on an enduro bike with 11 speed. I think this is going to be probably more applicable to downhill bikes where you have those smaller cassettes, those 7 speed nowadays. You'd have more space to play around with fitting some of these plastic spacers. I think it could really work for those downhill racers. I've been inspired by Aaron Gwynn, Rachel Atherton, amongst others, and Chris Porter to try out this, but some manufacturers have actually tried to find a solution to this problem. And the one that springs to mind is Canyon with their Sender Disconnect. Basically a system that actually tries to disconnect the cassette from the freewheel in the rear hub, so that at any point on the track, you can push a shifter, completely disconnects it so your suspension works really well, you can push the shifter back to normal and then pedal away. They said it's really just a concept bike at the moment. They've been testing it. It's kind of dangerous, as this system is. You know, you could really mess this up if you're in neutral and I try and pedal. You could go flying. Same with the Canyon Sender Disconnect. But they are saying that they'd love to make this automatic, so when you went to pedal, it then reconnected and away you go. So watch this space. We do still see quite a few variations of rear suspension design. One really interesting design is the Commensal Supreme 29er that has been ridden to the last two World Cup downhill victories by the young Frenchman, Amaury Piron. And it's got that really high pivot on the back of the bike. So it basically gives you a really good axle path. That rear wheel goes up and back. So when you're hitting obstacles, it's really easy for that rear suspension to work and be super active. However, that design does give you loads of pedal kickback. So to fix that, you've got that really high chain idler. So the chain goes up over the swing arm and then down to that chain ring to sort of fix that. However, what happens, the rear of that bike, actually the virtual chain stay length of that bike changes all the time as the rear wheel moves back and up. So that can be quite an unusual characteristic for the rider to get used to. One final thing on suspension design, Doddy the expert has informed me that actually Santa Cruz with their VPP system actually rely on some of that anti-squat and that chain tension to actually keep the suspension in that mid part of the travel. So when the bike sags in, the chain actually keeps it there to make that suspension work as they see fit. So it definitely does play a big part on how your suspension works. I do wonder if there's a better solution to this, but to be honest, I really enjoyed riding it. I might even leave it on my bike for a little bit longer, but let us know if you've got a better idea. Maybe a 3D printed spacer you could do at home. It's even got me wondering about BMX free coasters, if that would work. I don't know if the hub would fit, but the idea of it being able to roll backwards, I don't know. Let me know. Love to see your comments down below. If you want to see the original video, click up there for the feature. Give us a thumbs up if you're a geek as well, and hit that sub button for GMBN Tech.